The next part of our meeting today will be our humor session. And our humor master for today is none other than VK Chong. So let us invite VK Chong for his humor session.
Ladies and gentlemen, tonight I'd like to share with you the story about my first love. That was back in US 10 years ago. It was about my first girlfriend, okay? Her name is Carrie. Carrie is a person with a petite size, with thick glasses, and that's how she earned her top 20 MBA in Michigan. So, when I know Carrie, she was a colleague of mine. Okay. She's not those super hot type of girl. I would say that she belongs to those girls next door type. You can find her in several places. The first one, library. The second one, church or temple. The third one, in the office after 7 p.m. So we get to know each other before we started out on the day. So she invited me to a Nutcracker show in San Francisco. At that time, I actually secretly admired her, but I never dared to ask her out. I'm glad she took the initiative to crack some nuts. She invited me out for the Nutcracker show. Okay, the day I was very interested. So we went for the show, and after the show, she took out a piece of paper. She said, "Let us go to this steakhouse for dinner. Isn't it great when a girl's willing to plan out everything for the guys?" So I said, "Okay, never mind. Let's go for the restaurant to have our dinner." So the place that we went is actually House of Primates, located in San Francisco. It was one of the best steak that I ever had in my life. The place is a bit dim, you know, they light up the environment with candles, trying to set the mood. So I ordered a medium well steak that night. So I was busy working with my steak. I don't really pay attention to my food. But one thing I noticed, my steak tastes differently on that night. It tastes good, I mean it's okay, and it's also very different. So the only thing I figure out is different. But after I finished the whole plate, I saw a lot of blood on my plate. After I checked the waiter, then only I found out I have ordered a medium rare steak. Anyway, that's okay, fine. And moving on, after the dinner, she said, "Why not we go for some dessert?" Wow, I thought she's going to offer me a kiss. But that's not true. She pointed out a plastic bag with a cheesecake, a box of cheesecake inside it. So we drove all the way, with her pointing out the direction to me, we drove all the way to the top of the hill, when we can see the entire night scenery of Bay Area. It was very nice on that day. It was very windy as well. It's cold on the hill, and we can enjoy the scenery there. I will admit that I'm not a very romantic person. Because I don't know, until now, I still don't understand why girls love to see the moon, the stars. but then, they don't bother to find out, to learn about the stars and the moon. And then they wait for the guys to tell them about the stars and the moon. Very true. Is it true?
Yes.
Okay. So at that time we managed to find a bench, so we sat on top of it. We sat on a bench. And luckily I learned some good old tricks from the movie. I took out my leather jacket and I put it next to her. Immediately I can sense she feels very happy and touched through her facial expression. And after some time, I figure I have to seize the opportunity and tell her something. I want to tell her how I feel. So I turn my head to Carrie, say, "Carrie, I have something to tell you." And Carrie kind of shied away, you know, spoke in a very soft voice. What do you want to tell me? I said, Kerry, the view is good, but the wind is a bit cold. Can we have the cheesecake inside my car? It's my first day. Oh, I see, I still have some time. Okay, this is an extended version of let me go on for another last joke, okay? It's a joke about chicken, okay? There's two hens standing in front of the house talking to each other, okay? Then they saw a rooster coming back. One of the hens' husband. The rooster with his briefcase, all like this. Coming back to his house. So the hen, one of the hen, asked the other hen, "Hey, where did your husband work? Did your husband just change the job?"
So the next TME can actually ask you to continue.